Hey guys, what is up? Alex the Broder here, and welcome to The Terrible Old Man. Sorry about the editing issues with the little black bar on the side, but I could not get this game to fill up the entire capture screen. And let's begin. So Angelo, where are we going to blow this joint? When are we going to blow this joint? I say we head out tomorrow. It's a few hours drive to Boston. How long are we staying there for? Oh, I'd say just tonight. We gotta keep moving. And then we head back to Arkham? That's right. I've been talking to a guy up there who might be able to get us in some action, you know. Say, speaking of action, look at the dame over there. She's got something going on, doesn't she? She looks kinda stick figure-y to me, blurred out, but hey, incredible. Snack? Why don't you get your pasty ass over there and give her your best line? Maybe I will. Maybe I will. And get her some beers while you're at it. You've still got some cash from the old broad the other night. Yeah, I got a few bucks left. I don't have a dime. Poor ass bitch. Hell, that woman was so old she couldn't even get out of the house to spend her godforsaken dollars. Better old Manuel here spent it on hooch than let it sit there gathering dust for another 2 years before she bites it. Those aren't particularly nice people, eh? Damn right. Well then, get us some beers, boys. If she doesn't set up right, click to observe for inventory settings, move the cursor to the top of the screen. Okay, bomb it. Three beers over here. Where are you guys from? Boston in his mouth? None of your goddamn business. Just give me some beers. God, why don't you get him beers? Hey, this is my bar. You watch your manners, stranger. Tell him. Folk are nice in Kingsport. We look after each other. Three beers. That didn't go so great. Please? It'll be $2, my foreign friend. I've got to give him some cash. Okay, cool. I guess this might be the owner of this establishment. He's been giving us the look ever since we walked in the door. How about the man? I've been wanting to do a small talk with the locals on the sports. What a lovely person. Same thing. What about her? Let's see what she's up to. Let's see if we can get our man laid. Say there, miss. Can I have a word with you? Leave me alone, greaseball. Hey, no need for that kind of language, lady. I'm merely trying to conversate. I'm just conversating. Go and conversate elsewhere, maybe to your mother. Damn. Struck out against his neck. Suit yourself. You're some horrible person. Hey, Manuel. Yeah? What do you think of Kingsport? You're looking forward to Boston. What do you think of Kingsport? What do you think of Kingsport? It's close to the sea, too close to the sea for my taste. Girls filing up my jacket. I do not want this. Well then, what else shall we do tonight? Let's see where the evening takes. If I have some dough left, I feel we could paint the town snack. I don't know if that's just a pun on paint the town red or just the end of the sentence. I can't help but feel we went for a bit far for the last few nights. I've pissed away $100. You guys gonna need to be more careful. Invest your money, buy suits. And a little hat too. Hey. Suits are awesome. I'm on the suit party. You should buy suits. Hey, you stop ragging on my hat, okay? This is a finely crafted piece made by the best hat shop in all of Boston. Good one, Snack. Get him talking about his hat again. I screw the both of you. Looking forward to Boston. It'll be nice to have a rest before we go back, before we go on to Innsmouth. I agree. Later. Yeah. So who's going to give me money? Get the goddamn beer, Snack. No, no, give him money. Gotta give him some cash. Where do I get money from? Pictures. I don't want to look outside. Pictures. Some news clippings about an incident at the local port. They're from a paper called the Kingsport Bugle. Burgle. Clipped too quickly, my bad. nothing interesting, yeah, just dusty pictures of local goons. Hey, I'm at least a foreign goon, I'm exotic. I'd guess this might be the only mistake. So how do I give him money? Give him money! Cash. Oh, my bad. That would have helped. $2 right here. And I'm sure you're all just wanting to kill yourselves because I couldn't even click on something. 3 beers coming up. But I forgive me. Gosh darn it, the barrel is dry. I'm going to have to roll up a new one. Sit tight. Well then, if I asked for beer, surely you should have known I didn't have beer. It only took me 20 minutes to figure out how to give him money. Dickie eating his dinner tonight? Lovely name. Our service had a whole chocolate cake in front of his face and he didn't so much as blink. The boy's been affected. We've taken him to Doc Reeves, he'll get to the bottom of it. Well, he's only been acting strange since he's running with that old fella that other night. I should have let the boy out so late. What happened? You know that very old man, a former sea captain of some sort. You see him around town. Pays for his groceries and golden doubloons. Man be loaded. I've heard about him, yeah. Feeble and ancient. I heard he talks to bottles. He has lined up on the table inside his house. Losing his mind. Calls him names like Spanish Joe and Mate Ellis. It's as if he is speaking to his old crew. Yeah, most peculiar chap. Best avoided, I think. No need to upset such folk. Something you need to teach Dickie. A bit of respect. So what happened was Dickie threw a stone at his window, you see? Dude, your face is messed up. And the old man caught him in the act, gave him a good talking to, I bet. Dickie won't talk about what exactly happened. Oh dear. Interesting animations. He's a stupid boy. You go around throwing stones through old folks' windows, and while they aren't going to be happy, no matter how feeble they are. They throw stones through anyone's window, laugh less, and people are going to be pissed if you throw a rock through their window. Old, young, don't think it makes much of a difference. I've told him he's not leaving the house for a month, apart from going to his lessons. He must be quite a scary sight for a young lad to face. Fancy that, using gold coins for currency, the man must be sitting on a fortune. Tell me about it, I heard he... Captain Clipper ships in the east, uncountable years back, and bought back untold treasures. Sorry about the wait, here's your beers. Thanks, there we go. Took him a while, it's just ahead of the curve there, little. Boys, you're not going to believe it. You got a date with that fraud? No. He wishes. Yeah, I do. I think we got ourselves a job tonight. Well, spit it out then. I heard those two chaps speaking about a crazy old man who lives in the town. So Richie pays for things with gold doubloons. Yeah, I'll also put a smile on my face. Heck. Gold doubloons. Yeah, he's got a room in the house where he stands there talking to bottles. A rich and senile old fart. No, that's not very nice. Haha, this sounds like a cinch. Let's get in tonight and see what he's got on offer. Oh boy, this should be fun. Where's the old man's house then? I don't know, they didn't say. Find out, Shiznack. Find out, we may find riches tonight. So useless. Didn't even find out where the damned thing his house was. Say, fellas, what were you guys... that you guys were saying about an old man around these parts. What is it to you, stranger? Oh, I just overheard your story. He sounds like a character. Indeed he is. Shuffles about with his cane, dropping gold all over the show. Just follow him around and pick up his gold. What else do you know about him? Can't be too smooth. We can't just go straight for the... So where does he live? We have to work it out. What else do you know about him? You're asking a lot of questions, stranger. Yes, leave us be. Well... Never mind then. Said something about bottles. Sometimes people see him through his window with a line of curious bottles sitting up on a table. Each bottle has some sort of objects inside, pendulum some say. And he's been seen to chat to them, waving his arms about. I'm afraid the old chap has lost his mind too. Too much time at sea. He was a sea captain? Yeah, though back in Back in a time nobody remembers, rumor has it he spent decades in the Far East. Some say he talks to the Bars if they were his crew members. Maybe he kept the ashes in there. You don't know. Where does the old man live? His house is along the coast, a crumbling ancient pile. It is too. One of the oldest houses in Kingsport, I venture. What's the address? Oh, you think of visiting him, are you? Why on earth would you want to see him for? Treasure hunter, are you? Yes? Get out of here, but you don't want no thieves thinking up out of town. Yeah, get off here before I get the town guard. No, I mean, well, yeah, I appreciate treasures like every other man out there. I've no intention of robbing the old goat. So you can never put Robin there. You can be like, no, I want some advice. You know, where did he go? Where could I get some stuff from? But hey, well then, why do you want to know his address? Why should we trust you, outsiders? We're a traveling salesman. We wish to interview him for the local paper. We're his long-lost relatives. We've found something that belongs to him and wish to return it. We're from the tax department. He owes us money. Yeah, we're from the tax department. He owes us money. Then surely you would have his address on file. Get lost. Damn. Hello again. I suppose you still want to address. How do we know we can trust you, outsider? Well, we're not from the tax department. That didn't work. We're his long-lost relatives. Didn't you clearly know of Kingsport stock? Yeah, that was my bad. I didn't think that went through. Blah, blah, blah. We found something nice and we wish to return it. Good Samaritan thing. Just ignore everything else I've told you, all the lies. What's that? An old ornament. Let's have a look then. It's out in the car. Bulldust. Get out of here. Still didn't work. Hello again. Blah, blah, blah. We are traveling salesmen. That's what you're selling. Shoes. I sell shoes. Can you look at them? I need some new shoes. Sure thing. I'm wearing them right here. You're wearing a stock. What better way to advertise? I've got a box of them out in the car. And those shoes look very worn. You're full of it, stranger. Lies, lies, lies. Fair enough, I have lied to you about 5 times. We wish to interview him for the local paper. Oh yes, what's the name of the local paper then? Ah, I read this. The Kingsport Bugle. The Kingsport Bugle. Hey, yeah, that old rag has been printed for years. Lies, 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 and more lies. Well, hello again. Let's try this again. Well, we're travelling. We're local newspaper, but I'm not from the Bugle. We're from the Kingsport Commune. Wrong. You saw a pathological guy. Sure as hell seems it. Not pathological, more like I just want to make some money lying. Local paper, blah, blah, blah. The Telegraph. Wrong. Well, let's try one more time. I'm from the Times, just so you guys know. Figured that out. Just chose every wrong answer first, but I'm from the Times. Wrong. You saw a pathological. But I did every single one. Okay, what is this one? From the Kingsport Bugle portrait. A local Kingsport fisherman. Pictures. Nothing. Well, let's ask her. Seems to try every other option with everyone else. Do you know who knows anything about a rich old man who lives in town? That got her attention. Oh, you're back again. Don Juan doesn't stop trying tonight, does he? Not a chance. I'm a very persistent man. Damn straight. I don't know the old man. You're lying. Everybody must know. Leave me alone. Buy a manual, a dog, one of them real fancy ones. Gonna name him Jackson. Put him in my purse. Jackson the Chihuahua. You got the dress yet? I'm working on it. Barman, my friend. Yeah, well, I can tell with Broad over there. She's in here working all the time. Doesn't look like she's up to much. What's her line of work? Well, why don't you ask her yourself? Well, I can tell about those two guys at the bar. Hey, we're out here. Mind your own business, stranger. What he said. Fair enough. Do you know what old friend lives in town? can't say I do. You must. I don't gossip about locals, sir. It's a respectable town. Later. You know when you want those drinks refilled? Let me try the woman again? Probably have the answer sitting right in front of me and I don't know. Not you again, I'm busy. What are you working on apart from looking pretty? Well, my job requires a lot of thinking. Yeah, what is your vocation? I'm a journalist. Whoa, big shot. Why am I talking to you? I was thinking prostitute, so, hey. Bet on me. Say, you're out for the paper. Yeah, the Kingsport Daily Star. There we go. Now you get lost before writing an article about outsiders pestering local women in bars. Okay, okay, put your knickers on back on, lady. I prefer them off. Yeah, I know exactly where I work this time. Blah, blah, blah. Local paper, blah, blah, blah. The Kingsport Daily Star. I got mixed up before. I only said five wrong names, it's okay. We are from the Kingsport Daily Star. Nonsense. It's the truth. We are journalists from Boston. We do freelance work. Sounds like the old man can give us a great story. Imagine the tales he must have. Tales of exploration, treasure, and chivalry. You know what? Go ahead. I don't really believe you, but this is getting annoying, man. Well, I got annoying about 10 times ago. The old man lives up on Water Street's property, backs onto Ship Street near the shore. Outside his home are curious foreign standing stones, an unmistakable sight. Thanks, I appreciate it. Could have just told me. Fellas, I got the address. Damn straight, good work, Shazani boy? Where is it? Back entrance is on Ship Street by the harbour. Hey, we passed this street on the way here, it's just a few blocks away. Shazanak, you take the car. Silver and I will go on foot and meet you at the place. It's better we arrive separately. Nice plan. Let's go, boys, there's treasure to be had. An old man's pissed up. Let's hope we get some motherfucking money. Later that evening. Alright, we're all here. What's the plan, boss? Silver, you and I will go through this here gate. Shazanak, you stay on watch. Okay. Before we do anything though, it looks like there's a light up. Light on up there. Shazanak, can you have a better look? We gotta make sure you ain't watching us. Come in the car. It's not time to go yet. Okay. Should we climb the car street lamp? We could try climbing over that using a tube mod, but the gate seems more conventional choice. I'm going to the gates until he's all set to go. No, climb on the damn car! The trunk? The trunk is locked by solitary padlock. Stone. The stone's on the other side of the wall. I ain't going in there. Me, they can be the creeps. Do you have the key for the trunk? Oh balls, I do. Here you go. Ha! Thanks. What is the other key? No sweat. Okay, never mind. Don't get to ask him his other question. Suppose it should be time for small talk. We're gonna rob some old man. Okay, a good rob always comes prepared. We got a spyglass, a crowbar, and some masks. Yeah, so I suppose I need the spyglass. Look at the window. Hey! Dude, looks like some crazy old man with lots of shit in there. He's in there, he said the old fool looks like the easiest target we ever had. Good work, Snack. He really has talked to a bunch of bottles. As long as we're quiet here, we shouldn't notice us. He's engrossed in his queer little pursuit. Pathetic. You got our masks then? Damn straight I do. Masks. I need to prove to look some rich and silver. This allowed him to get away with some serious dough. wasn't insulting them, just merely a commentary on the standard of them faces. Here's the masks. Okay, we get that gate open. Nice people that I expect. Damn it, the thing is locked out. We don't know how to blah 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 blah. But it's nice and it must have all rotten socks or some such. Crowbar? Crowbar. Ding. And that is it. Ha, we're in. Good work, snack. Okay, Silver, let's go in. How are we gonna play it, boss? The old sea dog might not be too loquacious. Concerning his treasures, we may need to make him talk. That's if the gold is even hitting. If he's as senile as we suspect, he may have stacks of it piled up all around. Yeah, just piles of gold coins. Everywhere you look, piles of gold, piles of gold, piles of gold. That's how we roll. Don't go too hard on the old goat. We'll do what we need. Seems an old man can be easily muffled. That's a bit hardcore, man. Silver, you've hit the nail on the head. Or the old man, for that matter. Just act, wait for us in the car. He must be back in an hour at the most. Sounds like a plan, Richard. Remember, be gentle. Be gentle. 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 Creepy gate. Ew. It wasn't ominous at all. 1 hour later. Waiting in the car. What the hell's taking them so long? My thoughts exactly. That an old man screaming. What happened? They better not have knocked the old fellow off. I told him, I said we could don't go too hard on the old goat. And I can not read today. Almost days. Ah, here they come. Ain't them, my friend. Not with that music, ain't them. Hey old man. Friends, yo. I didn't do nothing. Just drove around the block. Okay. You ain't so friendly. Wow.
Little things make considerable excitement in little towns. Which is the reason that Kingsport people talked all that spring and summer about the three unidentifiable bodies, horribly slashed as with many cutlasses and horribly mangled as by the tread of many cruel boot heels, which the tide washed in.
Yeah, tide washed it in. Wasn't it all that creepy old man?
And some people even spoke of things as trivial as the deserted motor car found on Ship Street, or certain especially inhuman cries, probably of a stray animal or migratory bird, heard in the night by wakeful citizens.
Not at all related to the car, not like, oh, people drive a car, screams, maybe kill someone, nah, just animals, it's all good.
But in this idle village gossip, the terrible old man took no interest at all. He was by nature reserved, and when one is aged and feeble, one's reserve is doubly strong.
Hold in.
Besides, so ancient a sea captain must have witnessed scores of things much more stirring in the far-off days of his unremembered youth.
Oh, he did, and he was pretty chilled with it. He was like, this is okay. That was The Terrible Old Man, and it was pretty cool. Interesting little story, made in 30 days, so you know, it was a bit rushed, but it was a pretty cool story, pretty nice. And if you want to play it yourself, or you want to check out the developers, anything like that, I will have a link in the description below. And always, guys, thanks so much for watching, and I will see you guys in my next video. Or you'll see me, whichever works.